Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTV UK, and today I'm here to tell you 8 awesome facts you probably didn't know about Boss pedals. Everyone knows these beautiful little beasts. They are iconic, they sound fantastic, they're built like little tanks, and they do a lot for not a lot of money. I don't think I've ever met one guitar player who hasn't owned or owns a Boss compact pedal. My first ever pedal was a Boss TU2 chromatic tuner, and here it is. This is my Boss TU2. I use it every single day and it hasn't skipped a beat. You know why? Because it's a Boss pedal. My second ever pedal was a Boss SD1, which I still to this day harp on about as soon as I meet a guitar player, how great the Boss SD1 is. And it's not a lot of money. It's absolutely kick ass. So if you have a favorite Boss pedal, comment down below what it is and why you dig it. There's been so many different variants and colors of Boss pedals over the years, from simple tuners to game-changing synth pedals, acoustic simulators, and legendary overdrives, delays, and distortions. Boss are on one hell of a ride with no signs of stopping. And there's some interesting little details and facts in their illustrious history. So without further ado, here are 8 awesome facts you probably didn't know about Boss pedals. Number 1, the name Boss was chosen because the founder, Ikutaro Kakahashi, wanted a name with leadership connotations. Started in 1974 as a derivative of the now equally as legendary Roland brand, Boss hit the ground running making amazing quality guitar goodies. The first one being the B100 The Boss. It wasn't even a Boss pedal, the pedal itself was just called the Boss B100. And what that was a clip-on preamp and pickup system you could use to amplify your acoustic guitar. The first proper Boss foot pedal effect was the Boss CE1 Chorus Ensemble, but not the Chorus Ensemble we know to this day, the compact one. This was 1976. This was a big lad, you had to plug this guy directly into the wall, but it was absolutely awesome. It was the chorus and vibrato taken from the legendary Roland JC120 amplifier. The jazz chorus, one of the best sounding cleans and choruses you will ever hear. They also made a couple of other big lad pedals. They made the DB5 distortion, the GE10 graphic equalizer, and the BF1 flanger. It wasn't until the late 70s they must have thought, these pedals are pretty big. They're awesome, but they're pretty big. Let's make some compact pedals and take over the guitar world, which they did, which leads on to fact 2. The first ever Boss compact pedal sold was the OD1 in 1977. The Boss compact range of pedals are the best-selling guitar pedals of all time. The line started in 1977 with the OD1, the Overdrive, then the Phaser, the PS1, the parametric EQ known as the Spectrum, the SP1, the graphic EQ known as the GE6, a touch wah, the TW1, and the compressor, the CS1. But the first one to start it all was that little yellow box of glory with 2 knobs, the OD1. It has since evolved into the Boss OD3, which you can still buy. Seriously, get yourself to a PMT store and try a Boss OD3 out. It kicks ass. And it only takes 2 minutes of Googling to find out how many of our favorite guitar players have used the iconic Boss OD over the years. Speaking of famous guitar players, this nicely nuzzles into fact 3, which is if you want to sound like a guitar hero, your icons, get yourself a Boss DS1. As of right now, September 2020, the Boss DS1 is only £55. It's a legendary pedal, the little orange box that everyone knows. Kurt Cobain, Gary Moore, Steve Vai, John Frusciante, all huge users of the Boss DS1. It's a very simple pedal, laid out the same as the rest of the Boss pedals. 1 volume, 1 drive, and 1 tone to get some iconic legendary tones used by most of our favorite guitar players. It's absolutely crazy. It was released in 1978 and there's been a couple of little changes over the years, first in the early 90s, then again in the late 2000s, but that legendary tone is still there. Super easy to use and I can't believe the price of it, it's crazy. The DS1's absolutely amazing. Fact number 4, Boss have released over 120 unique pedal models. I seriously think if I was given a week, I couldn't think of 120 guitar effects, let alone mass produce them and put them in fantastic little boxes like what Boss have done. I mean, besides the staples like the Blues Driver and the evolving pedals like the OD1 to the OD3, Boss have made some wacky and wonderful pedals over the years, whether it be tweaking a one that's already very popular, like I remember they made a fantastic high band flanger a couple of years ago, the HF2, that was kick ass. And they made the Fender range a few years ago as well, where you could get your Marshall to sound like a Fender bassman with a Boss pedal, or get a 65 Fender reverb in a Boss pedal. up to now where they're making game-changing pedals, like the vocoder. The vocoder is amazing. Plug your guitar and your microphone into it, use it as a talk box, get a choir on the go, and give your guitar a bit more of a vocal quality, all the way to the SY1, which is the first synth pedal where you haven't got to include a pickup into your guitar. It tracks amazing. You can get synth sounds, brass sounds, and everything in between. The SY1 is fantastic. 120 pedals, and we know it's not stopping there. I can't wait to see what Boss have in store for us in the future. Number five, they're made the way they are so you don't knock the knobs. If you think about it, most pedals are designed as such. Very flat, knobs on the top, turn on or off with the switch at the bottom. You will knock the knobs. I've got size 12 feet and I hate having to sellotape my lovely pedals onto my board. But with Boss, the reason they're designed in such a way is simply you can turn them on and off and not hinder your lovely settings. Because there's nothing worse, isn't there, guitarists out there? Getting that sweet setting and you're in the moment on stage and you knock your delay pedal, making it go absolutely crackers. These are designed in such a way so when you stamp on it, no matter how big or small your foot is, those knobs ain't getting turned. Number six, they were the first pedal with silent switching. Prior to 1977, most pedals that you turned on and off had a big click to either turn on or off. We all know that click. It's the audible slight little delay in noise when you tap your pedal on and off. After 77, Boss and the compact range got rid of that lovely click by having very fancy scientists and wizards in Japan make a nice silent switching system so you can turn these pedals on and off and not hinder your performance with any loud clicks or drops in volume. What an accolade to have, the first pedal company to introduce silent switching. I hope someone got a raise that day. Actually, to facilitate the silent switching, they had to include a buffer into the Boss pedals. Now, Boss pedals are the easiest way to get a buffer into your signal chain. If you don't know what a buffer is, it boosts your signal, keeping it legit, okay? The more guitar cable you've got, the longer the distance between your guitar and the amplifier, the more tone that's lost. And if you have true bypass pedals, that's just like adding extra cable into the mix, and there'll be nothing left by the time it hits your fantastic amplifier. You need a buffer to maintain your signal tone, and Boss pedals are the easiest way to get one in your chain. Number seven, one of my favorites. Prince's pedal board consisted mostly of Boss pedals. Now, it's a common misconception when you see Boss pedals. They're so common. Everyone's got Boss pedals, like I said, and they're not the most expensive pedals in the world. They're not as expensive as fancy boutique ones. Does that mean that these are worse than boutique ones? Surely not. Not to someone like Prince. The legendary Prince loves a good Boss pedal. Octavers, phasers, overdrives, blues drivers, he's used them all over the years, and a quick little Google search can see his fantastic semicircle Boss equipped pedal board. He's even got a turbo distortion on there, the little orange pedals, which is a crazy pedal, but Prince uses one, so you know it's got to be good. It's a common misconception when I see people turn their nose up at cheaper pedals, thinking that the boutique thing is better. Granted, that might do something different, but you can't beat the original Boss compact pedals. If Prince likes them, then you know they're good. And finally, number eight, my favorite, Boss coined the name Overdrive when it comes to guitars with the OD-1 in 1977. Now, before you kick off in the comments thinking this was a thing before that, the name Overdrive wasn't. There was overdrives before that, but they weren't called overdrives. There was distortions, there was fuzzers. Tube screamers, I believe, were a thing. But was it called an overdrive? No, it was called a tube screamer. The Overdrive name came out with the OD-1 in 1977, and that is one hell of a plaque you should have on your wall, Mr. Boss. I invented the overdrive. The name, at least. It's awesome. Obviously, I know the words overdrive weren't invented by Mr. Boss. It was a thing in the car world for years prior, but it was the first time we'd seen it on a guitar pedal. And if you know differently, comment down below and let me and the other folk know. But if not, I think that's the truth. And now you guys know that Boss invented the word overdrive when it comes to pedals. So there we have it, ladies and gents. Eight awesome facts about Boss pedals that you probably didn't know. These things are legendary, and there's a Boss pedal for every single occasion. Whether you simply want to tune up, have some legendary overdrive with the OD3, OD1, or DS1, make your guitar sound like a crazy synth, be metal as hell with a metal zone, or simply be as cool as Prince, there's one suit every guitarist on the planet. Actually, I want to add a little thing in now as well. On Boss's website, there's a timeline of every single Boss pedal that's ever been made with the year it was made. Please comment down below the Boss pedal that was released, the year you were born. I think it'd be quite cool to see the Boss timeline in our viewers' timeline as well. That'd be really cool. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTV UK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on Boss pedals, get your fine self to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding PMT stores where you can try these bad lads out. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, this has been a lot of fun. I'll see you next time.